到底台海会不会爆发战争？美国的中情局局长 Burns， 他过去是美国驻俄罗斯的大使，是外交官出身的。他最近在 Georgetown 二月二号外交政策的一场演讲上面，他有一点改口。他不再像过去在美国国会的时候，他认为2027年的时候爆发战争的可能性非常高，因为据他们所得到的消息，习近平已经下令必要的时候2027年之内解决台湾问题。他改口了，他说俄乌战争似乎使得习近平清醒一点，但是本周还是有一些美国的军事将领提出了台海战争的可能性。他是美军上将米尼汉，米尼汉呢，他认为台海战争最快是2025年，他有他的逻辑推演，我们待会儿会看到相关的一个报道。但是民主党的军事委员会资深成员 Adam Smith 他的看法并不相同，他认为目前为止他看不到战争非打不可的迹象，战争并非不可避免，情势即使有所危险，美国应该有所准备没有错，但是相信有一定的能力，美中的对话可以避开冲突。另外，美国前任的财政部部长，就是在2008年小布希时期的财政部长 Henry Paulson， 他以前是著名的高盛的总裁，他最近在 Foreign Affairs 写了一篇文章，叫 America's China Policy is not working。他的意思是说，你现在美中的政策根本就不可行，因为中国是一个巨大的一个市场，你不可能叫全世界跟着你一起背个中国，这是第一点，连美国的企业都未必愿意接受。其次，他也不认为台海危机必然会发生，他的看法是美国的主流论述里头认为台海战争必然发生，因此叫大家背个中国，因此叫台湾的企业一到美国去，里头充满了拜登政府自己的计算，而他的看法是美国跟中国必须对话。
Taiwan is perhaps the most sensitive flashpoint between the U.S. and China. Some experts warning that Beijing's use of force to claim what it sees as its rightful territory is drawing closer.
一名美国空军上将明确地讲出开战时间将会是在2025年。
The Washington Post is reporting that General Michael Minihan sent a memo to troops under his command that said, quote, I hope I'm wrong. My gut tells me we will fight in 2025.Taiwan's presidential elections are in 2024. They're going to offer Xi a reason, he believes. United States presidential elections are obviously also in 2024 and will offer Xi a distracted America. He says Xi's team and opportunity are all aligned for 2025. Now, of course, this is what he is saying. Now, this is not necessarily the reflection of the consensus of the U.S. military. Republican Congressman Mike McCaul did tell Fox yesterday he agrees with the general's assessment.
I hope he's wrong as well. I think he's right, though.
All right, the Pentagon is distancing itself right now from a memo by a U.S. Air Force general. According to a statement from the Pentagon press secretary, the focus of the U.S., quote, remains on working alongside allies and partners to preserve a peaceful, free, and open Indo-Pacific.
这也已经不是美国第一次公布中国攻台时刻表了。2021年3月，美国海军上将戴维森在参议院军事委员会作证中表示，中国近年在印太地区持续扩张，解放军攻台已是箭在弦上，最晚不会晚于2027年。美国国防部也于2021年11月发布2021年中国军力报告，预测解放军将在2027年启动武统大规模两栖登陆，夺取台湾外岛。2022年10月，美国海军作战部长吉尔戴在受访时表示，中国将于2023年启动武统，美国必须有所行动。再来就是今年1月，美国智库 CSIS 公布了美中台海兵推报告，假设解放军将在2026年攻打台湾。但习近平若决定攻台，以中国和全球资本主义供应链的进出口关系比俄罗斯紧密太多，攻击台湾，中国自己将面临重大的经济衰退，他甚至必须比普丁还更疯狂，在所谓的2025年武统台湾。现在一个关键的问题是，华府的警告我们应该全盘接受吗？ 还是所谓台海危机是逼迫台积电等科技制造业回流美国，并且以此围堵中国的完美论述。时间倒回1964年，美国总统詹森为扩大战争决策权，公开了当年8月2号由美国驱逐舰在越南东京湾遭北越炮艇攻击。
August 2nd, the United States Navy destroyer Maddox, on patrol in international waters of the Gulf of Tonkin, begins to track three unknown craft approaching from the northwest. They are identified as North Vietnamese PT boats, armed with torpedoes and 37mm guns. When warnings from the Maddox fail to stop the oncoming PT boats, she opens fire.
美军驱逐舰自卫还击，击沉了一艘北越鱼雷艇。随后，美国国防部又公布，又有北越鱼雷艇再次攻击美军军舰。8月4号午夜，时任美国总统詹森出现在电视上，向全美宣布派遣突击部队向北越展开轰炸。詹森总统还利用这起事件说服国会在8月7日通过东京湾决议，授权总统采取一切必要步骤，包括使用武力来保卫南越及其邻国。直到2005年10月，《纽约时报》引述美国国家安全局历史学家汉约克的调查发现，这个用来说服国会授权总统导致战事扩大的8月4日北越攻击根本不存在。
The night of the controversial battle, the Maddox did not take any damage or suffer any losses, which is but one of many reasons why Senate investigators now believe there never was any battle that night. The North Vietnamese always said they were never there, that it was simply an excuse to get into the war.
1964年是总统大选年，詹森总统把越战推成选举焦点。同年11月，他以超过60%的选票赢得总统大位。明年又是大选年，不断被提及的台海危机真实性有多高呢？曾在川普时期担任白宫国家安全顾问的退役将军麦马斯特说，米尼汉将军的预测真实性很高。
Hey, this is exactly what General Minahan should be doing. This, he's the head of Air Mobility Command. And it's his job to be ready to fight tomorrow, right? He doesn't get to pick whether we go to war or not, but he has to tell his command to get ready. What he said is, hey, I've got a gut feeling that we're in a period of increasing danger. And I think he's right about that. You know, he's talked about the Taiwanese election in 2024. If the Chinese Communist Party doesn't see the outcome they want in Taiwan, then I think the chances go up.If China continues to encounter the internal difficulties they've had, economically, financially, the real estate sector, does that make an attack on Taiwan more likely? I think maybe it does in terms of Xi's desire to maybe stoke nationalism and get people's minds off of the internal problems. But most importantly, Errol, I say, hey, Xi Jinping has said he's going to do it, you know, and many of his speeches, he seems to be preparing the Chinese people for war. And of course, it's our military's job.To be ready.
华盛顿邮报以“为何一位美国将军预测2025美中开战”为题，分析了米尼汉将军的说法。报道指出，习近平扬弃了韬光养晦的策略，煽动了民族主义情绪，并采取强硬的外交立场。北京的观点是，美国应该为外交和军事紧张负全部责任。2022年8月，时任众议院议长佩洛西成为自1997年以来访问台湾民主国家的最高级别美国政治人物之后，一份关于中国台湾战略的官方白皮书指责华盛顿利用台湾遏制中国。
挟洋谋独没有出路，以台制华注定失败。
美国在亚太地区围堵中国的布局也一步步成型。
The United States military is moving into the Philippines. Large numbers of U.S. troops will have access to 4 Filipino bases.
And these efforts are especially important as the People's Republic of China continues to advance its illegitimate claims in the West Philippine Sea.
The U.S. Marine Corps opened a new military base. It's on the Pacific island of Guam.It's called Camp Blas. The base will host as many as 5,000 U.S. Marines. The NATO chief is touring Asia as we speak. The U.K. is pushing for India and Japan to join the AUKUS military alliance. These may seem like unrelated developments, but when you connect the dots, the bigger picture emerges. The U.S. is readying its military and its allies for a potential conflict with China.
外交事务近日刊登一篇文章，作者鲍尔森是小布希时期的财政部长。他撰文反驳当下美国主流论述“美中冲突不可避免，台海危机必然发生”的看法。这位出身高盛集团总裁的前美国财政部长认为，美国对华政策只为美国国内政治考量，完全行不通。他提出，美国目前试图将志同道合的国家组成联盟，特别是亚洲和欧洲的民主国家制衡中国，但这个战略不会奏效，因为中国对于欧洲、东协，哪怕韩国、澳洲，甚至日本，都是巨大的市场。美国的策略伤害了中国，也伤害美国，两败俱伤。鲍尔森表示，尽管美国阻止多年，但中国在2020年超越美国，仍然成为了欧盟最大的贸易伙伴。他认为，美中决策者应该更频繁的会面，更坦诚的交谈。美中一战是毁灭性的，而且台湾一不小心即成为废墟。
But the worry is it's an escalation that could push Beijing closer to the brink, where one step or misstep could lead to an all-out war.